This is Martin McConnell, and I know I normally don't do this kind of stuff, but I'm doing it today. So I just got these new trays from Greenhouse Megastore. And I've been doing some comparisons with my trays. These are, these guys are getting worn out, my old ones, and so they're just not quite so good anymore. The new ones, to be perfectly honest, I'm not impressed, but for the cost, I didn't expect to be thoroughly impressed. These are, just your basic planting trays. They're 10-20s. This is what I use to grow microgreens, and so having a lot of trays on hand is usually a good thing around here. Right now I've got eight live trays growing in there, and I'm just a small outfit, so I'm not huge or not trying to be anybody special, but in case anybody's curious, I figured I'd do this little video comparison real quick. And this is a tray that was bought from Ace Hardware. This is what I've been using this year. So I'm just going to talk about basically the differences between the two trays and why you might consider giving Greenhouse Megastore a shot. I'll probably be buying from them again. I'm not lying about that. But the trays themselves are not super impressive. Like I said, dimensionally, they're more stable along the skinny axis. So if I take this and back out a little bit, take it, flop it a little bit in my hand, it just feels more stable than this one, which is kind of flimsy in this direction. I think that's an engineering thing more than anything, because you'll see these have these little bubble ribs like you see on a lot of trays online nowadays, whereas this tray from Ace has straight ribs all the way across. And I think it loses something to the side-to-side stability having those. Now, the reason I had to get new trays is because this edge right here, this one's actually okay, but these edges are starting to snap and they're developing cracks all the way down them on my planting trays. And that's really, really frustrating because I fill these things with dirt and they're loaded with microgreens. So when I'm ready to harvest, this tray is going to be carrying around 3 to 5 pounds of weight. And that's maybe not exactly what these are intended for, but they need to be used for it out here. So the biggest difference between these guys, I mean, this weighs 130 grams, measured it. The new ones weigh 150 grams, so they're a little bit more sturdy, probably a little more than 10% increase in weight, which contributes good. These edges are a little bit sturdier, but not much. But the biggest difference on these two guys is the cost. These trays at Ace cost me about $2 a tray. These ones, I don't remember the exact price because I had a lot of shipping, but they were much, much cheaper. Get a 10-pack. I was able to buy 30 trays before shipping. I think it was around 30 bucks. So you're looking at about $1 a tray versus $2 a tray. And these are a little bit better. So cost-wise, half as much, a little tougher, even if it was the same quality. I would still go on this side just because the cost difference. So the quality's there to justify the cost anyways. What I also did, because they were so cheap, I was able to get these. Now, these are daisy trays, move out of the way. So basically, this is just a plastic tray, and this is solid molded. So, it's got a little bit of flex to it by itself, but you can actually use this to carry, lighter produce. Probably not a lot, but this is going to flex under a lot of weight by itself. But, the biggest difference with these is along the rib, and I don't know if you can see it here. Yeah, it's got these little plastic connections all the way down the rib, and this is because these are not really meant to be stacked in the same way that a normal tray is meant to be stacked, so they can get away with having these sturdier ribs. And this gives your fingers something to grab onto when you're first picking it up before you can get it by the bottom. That just makes things a little easier, a little sturdier. And if you take one of my little weakling trays and toss it in there, let's put a rock in it. Then I can pick it up and it doesn't, you know, it doesn't have the warping and flexing, and I can grab by the daisy tray so I'm not pulling these edges and cracking them. So because of the lower cost, I was able to get daisy trays, and those are going to be a lifesaver for me. That's the real structural integrity here that I'm going for, and I think with those, this is going to work out just fine. So got a lot of trays, real cheap. They're not, you know, it's nothing to write the paper about as far as their toughness compared to a normal tray. Like I said, they're more stable along this skinny axis. They're sized appropriately, and they look like they'll work. They'll hopefully work for me for a little while. But that's pretty much it, side by side comparison. So this is going to be a little bit better than the stuff you can get at the store, and a lot cheaper. And if you can get them shipped FedEx, then you can save a lot of money. But unfortunately, I needed to get my trays fast, and I don't get FedEx here because I'm not a normal residential address. So these will, you know, I wanted to pick them up from the post office, and that incurs a lot of extra charge, which is kind of an annoyance. But when I order my next batch, I have some friends that own businesses, and I can have them ship directly to their businesses, and I can get my cost savings that way. But like I said, this I just needed quick, fast. So like I said, my other trays are falling apart, so I needed something new to replace them with, and I think these guys are going to work just fine. If you really need something a little tougher, I did some quick tests with having these stacked in a daisy tray, and that seems to be the best thing. So if you've got trays that are already good, get daisy trays, and they'll last a whole lot longer, because the stuff that's going to break is going to break from use, and wear is basically your fingers prying up these edges and forcing them to crack over time. The plastic is a little bit different. I mean, it feels kind of the same, but it's got a slightly different feel to it, so it's probably a different formulation. Hopefully, that will add some stability over time, that the plastic maybe won't corrode or go away as fast. But the big thing is, most people that are getting trays use them once a year. You pull them out, put your seedlings in them, and then they get tossed in a closet for the rest of the year, and people are talking about seasons. Well, these little black trays, I've been, since the beginning of the year, growing microgreens in, so I'm using them every week, week in, week out, and they have actually held up pretty well. I mean, in a comparison of years, I've probably gotten about 10 to 15 years of use out of each of these little black trays, just in the last 6 months. And probably more than that, actually, but depending on your usage. But the new ones, I expect them to hold up just as well. And basically, I don't want to be buying new trays every 6 months, so that's why I got the daisy tray carriers. But yeah, if you're going for a quality increase, I definitely recommend the daisy trays, because a daisy tray will up the quality of your tray system very, very quickly. And these are about the same price. They're about $1 a pop. So they were roughly the same price as the trays themselves. What would be nice for me is if they just took these daisy trays and molded the solid plastic inside there of these guys, and that would make like the perfect tray, right? But they're not doing that yet. So if you want higher quality, you're going to have to pay for it, $6 to $8 a tray for something like that. But for the moment, I think, for my purposes at least, this combination is going to work. So that's the difference between the trays. There's not a lot of difference, but the biggest difference for me was the cost. These are super cheap, and they're a little bit better. And then I had enough money to get the daisy trays, which are also super cheap. And a combination of a daisy tray with one of these, that basically makes the whole system workable for me. And just tossing these around and putting them through various little stress tests and stuff out here, I'm pretty happy with my purchase overall. So go ahead and give Greenhouse Megastore a shot if you're just looking for trays. If you're looking for something that's really, really super, super tough, these are not for you. You're looking more in the $5 to $15 per tray category. But if you're looking for a simple setup that's not too expensive, and it's just basically the same price you're going to get at the store for your regular trays, a combination with daisy trays and regular trays, this is going to hold up just fine. I already know it is just by looking at it. And then if you need something to take your stuff to the farmer's market, like I said, these aren't super heavy duty, but they will definitely work for carrying stuff like tomatoes or carrots or cabbages and stuff like that and having something to display them into. So they've got a secondary backup use on the daisy trays. Anyways, that's my little spiel. I'm going to be doing more video game stuff today.